With some wonderful housing stock, Yorkshire is one of the best places to find country houses, and the prices are always cheaper up north.
What usually comes out of them has a little hint of that quality and that country house gold dust, which it all seems to be sprinkled with, when you find the right bits.
Sprawling Fawcett Hall is a Grade 1 listed house, recorded in the 11th century Domesday Book, but as it stands today, is mainly Georgian, rebuilt in the 1740s. After living and farming here for 90 years, the Heathcote family have now decided it's too big for a family home. They're downsizing and putting the house on the market. James Heathcote is looking to clear out before he moves.
We are going to move to smaller premises without a doubt, and there's an awful lot of furniture that's going to need to be sold.
When we hear of a country house coming up for sale, particularly a large 18th century one, we want to know. It has the potential to spill its guts out. You never know what's going to come out of them.
Wow, that is fabulous, isn't it? I'm going to say it. Look at the proportions. Look at it. Look at the proportions.
This is a hidden gem. This house I didn't know about. This is something I've never seen pictures of, and it's incredible. The scale and then the colour and the paint on it that started to wear away and its setting in the landscape. It's really quite astonishing.
Drew.
Drew, hi.
How do you do?
Nice to meet you. James.
Hi, MT. Yeah. You all right? How are we doing?
Well, I like the outside.
Yes.
I love the outside. I'm even more keen to get inside now.
Come on,
have a look. Ooh, it gets better, doesn't it?
Yeah.
OK, so what's up for grabs? Is it anything?
Well, come on through, we'll have a...
There's a few bits. I mean, that's quite nice. That's nice. That's nice.
These are lovely, aren't they?
They're beautiful. So what else have we got in here, then? That's very lovely. Would that be for sale, potentially?
Yes?
Yep.
Little rosewood sofa table. English, late Regency period, 1820, possibly Irish, nice, gentle barley twist to it, original casters, completely untouched. Little bit of damage.
This striking 19th century table was made of Brazilian rosewood. It was worth around £1,350.
What would you like for it? Or do you want me to start giving you prices?
You can give me a price.
500?
Hmm, yeah.
Happy with that?
Yeah.
Fine, so I do. Marvellous.
It's too much. It's the first thing I'd have liked to have paid sort of 350. We're going over the top, maybe four at a push. We're paying £100 extra because we're through the door. We've just paid the admission fee.
Striking while the iron is hot, Drew continues to search through every room.
These.
Yeah.
Cockfighting chairs.
Is that what they are?
Yep.
In one of the bedrooms is a pair of 19th century cockfighting chairs. Now, these won't have actually been cockfighting chairs, but they're in the manner of the 18th century chair that was used for this awful purpose. These are very small and they're upholstered badly. But there's a pair. One, I wouldn't bother with. Two, I want to know.
To give you a proper value on them, I need to cut that fabric. I need to make a hole. I'll be gentle, but I need to see what's underneath it.
Yeah, yeah.
Do it gently. Look at this.
What's under there?
Beautiful.
Mm.
Why would you cover that?
I was just thinking the same. Yeah.
Luckily, the upholsterer is a lazy sod.
Why?
Because he's just gone straight over the top of it all. He's not stripped it. Can we do the same on that one?
Yeah. Yeah.
We're adding value to it anyway, James, you know?
Drew has to go to these lengths, even if it means destroying the current covers on the chairs, because if they match, he's quids in.
What can I get for these? If the upholstery is the same on that one, £800.
Yeah. Sounds good to me.
Drew's offer is based on the chair having exactly the same fabric as its twin.
Oh, what's happened?
Yeah, he's removed this one.
That is such a shame.
Mm. So what he's done is he's done this one properly, and then he's gone to this one. He said, oh, I can't be arsed.
These 19th century cockfighting chairs would have been a matching pair, covered in the same close-stitched needlepoint embroidery. With only one chair in original fabric, the pair were worth around £2,000.
I'm going to have to buy them now anyway. I've wrecked them for you.
I'll stand on. I'll stick to my original price.
Right.
Good.
Yep.
OK.
One had the original needlepoint upholstery underneath it, the other one didn't. It also had a lot of rot in one of the legs. But it's a pair. And a pair is so useful to me to sell. A pair makes my life easier.
Right.
Let's carry on.
Yeah, let's carry on.
Have you got any more furniture you want us to destroy?
Having bought a table and the chairs, Drew's still on the hunt for something to seal the day.
This is to go, to clear?
Yes.
Oh, that's nice. You haven't got any more of those, have you?
Yes.
You have? How many of these have you got?
10 or a dozen.
Really?
Yeah.
It takes a bit of hunting about.
Now then, the rest of those chairs are over here.
5 + 2 carvers, we're missing one.
But eventually, they locate a set of matching dining chairs.
There we go.
Oh, yes. Easy.
Happy days.
Happy days, there's another one.
Minus.
Boom.
A leg.
Ah, yeah.
So it's clearly a set of mahogany dining chairs, again, from that same period, around 1820. They're in a loose Chippendale form. They have a very nice leather upholstered seat.
These elegant dining chairs with leather seats, including two carvers, were worth around £2,500.
So we've got £8,000.
Right.
Deal. Marvellous.
We end up paying £1,000 for the lot, but they do need some work. But they're probably £2,500 minimum done. Maybe even £3,000 because the leather on them's very good. We're privileged to get into these buildings. Given the opportunity, go. Buy as much as you can. Particularly if they're selling up the house, they're going to be much more interested in gaining as much money as they possibly can from it before they sell the building. The perfect opportunity, a very, very good day out in the country.